Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
You have found it, the tip of the spear, the front line in the fight to defend human liberty worldwide as open, hardcore, textbook tyranny unfolds on a global scale. The United States is at the heart of that battle. Great evil, but also great good resides in this nation, as it does in every other corner of the world. But the United States is the hotbed. It is where the great struggle is centered. We're going to be live here for the next 3 hours. Constitutional scholar, pastor, patriot, former presidential candidate Chuck Baldwin's going to be joining us to talk about the NDAA, the increasing tyranny, the announcements that U.S. citizens will be tortured, killed, and disappeared here in the United States. The announcements that the United Nations now openly rules the United States through their puppet president. The Pentagon has lined up and sworn allegiance to the UN and openly stated Congress has no authority. Absolute, in-your-face declaration of sedition and warfare against the Republic. And those words aren't even strong enough. Understand, that's not rhetoric. That is the U.S. Code, the Constitution, Bill of Rights, Declaration of Independence, global precedent for thousands of years, right back to the Rubicon in B.C. 49 with Julius Caesar. How does Encyclopedia Britannica describe it? In fact, guys, print me that Crossing the Rubicon again. Just that whole printout from Britannica. And Wikipedia just quotes Britannica in that section I was reading, where it said when he brought his military in and declared himself the ruler, he declared war on the Roman Republic. And there was a civil war, and he was successful and became Caesar, or king. Translates really to elephant. Caesar, Kaiser, means elephant. And elephants were seen as the symbol of royalty thousands of years ago. So it translates into that. And you saw what happened. Corruption began to pour in. And a lot of people say, okay, yeah, we are going into an authoritarian system. Congress is becoming ceremonial, just as the Roman Senate did. What's the big deal? Well, they're going to take most people's property. They're going to conscript your children for warfare. The police are fully militarized against us. Kurt was showing me video and news articles all over the country. Police are now wearing full U.S. Army uniforms. Just it doesn't say U.S. Army. So it's all indistinguishable. All of our own tax money to build a giant military system against us, drones, robots, surveillance, forced inoculations, banning of non-GMO crops, attacking Amish, attacking farmers, savage attacks on people selling cordwood on the side of the road, Agenda 21, rural roads to be torn up and railways to be spiked, just absolute deindustrialization, dark ages, by design, scientific bedlam. It's here. And the tyrants are testing. They're criminally training everyone to come before Congress and say, yeah, you don't run jack diddly squat. There is no oversight. And not only is the president a Caesar, that would be one thing if he was an American Caesar. You might get good, you might get bad. It's treason, it's tyrannous, Maximus, it's horrible. It's the maximum tyranny within the domestic confines. This is worse. This is a puppet tyrant, a puppet office of the National Traitor Council, the National Security Council, the National Sedition Council, and the Joint Chiefs of Treachery and Crime, all openly saying, we work for foreign powers. And who runs the IMF, World Bank? Who runs the UN? Who runs NATO? The open private banks. In fact, guys, during the break, print me an article. You'll see it in news or web. Just type in banker coup over Europe. And it's like Newsweek and Time are like, it's great. The bankers took over without firing a shot. Gee, can we have foreign bankers run us? They actually say that. Gee, I wish I had me some foreign bankers running me. It's fun, yeah. This is going to be an incredibly important live Friday radio show. It is 11 a.m. in 8 minutes, Central Standard Time. Thank you so much for joining us. Unfortunately, our deep analysis of the last 17 years of the global corporate fascist New World Order structure has been absolutely accurate, except in one facet. It's one thing to forecast and see their own battle plans, much of which are public. It is another thing entirely to actually see it unfolding. It has so many more nightmarish facets. It is so much more aggressive and fast-growing and openly attacking everything that is good and wholesome, because that can always be a center of resistance to evil. So it's going after everything wholesome, everything good, everything natural, overturning the existing order of creation with genetic engineering, chemical, biological weapons, endless war, bondage, death, slavery, propaganda constantly that the tyrant global corporate government is loving and good and wants to help everybody. It literally dumbs down populations, manipulates good people into serving evil, attacks the family, the nation state, the family farm, everything. It is unmitigated, pure pit of hell evil. Because you see, in history, corrupt forces compete with each other for the power, for the ring of Sauron. And only the most cunning, only the most given over to absolute pure ruthlessness and beyond ruthlessness and enjoyment of pain, suffering, humiliation, death, poverty, humiliation, trampling humanity, being trampled upon, pressing on the nerve of power, the priest of power, the priest of abomination, desolation, and the great hell that they're conjuring. Governments killed 262 million, not counting military casualties, in the 20th century, and they are preparing to engage in megadeth upon megadeth. Megadeth to the power of infinity, because they will kill and kill and kill and only allow small amounts of life to continue so it can be killed. I don't know if killing a million is a megadeth. What is killing a billion? In fact, maybe search that. If a megadeth is over a million, what is a billion? Because the globalists all openly say, from Bill Gates to Ted Turner to the UN, they want world government to carry out an orderly extermination. But then Bill Gates is funding Kony 2012, this fake grassroots movement about invading Africa to save some children from some warlord who might have 500 soldiers under him. And if he has committed crimes, it's a micron of the president of Uganda and others who've been involved in the decades of genocide that's gone on. And now they've got George Clooney and everyone. Yes, invade, war, Afrikaans in place in Uganda, in Kenya, in other areas, in now the area they've bombed out and leveled of Libya. The genocide's now starting there. And it'll be millions and millions killed. And then they'll say, oh, the UN didn't know this was happening. And all the trendies will still feel good about themselves. And I've run into these trendy liberals. They're not liberals. These are scientific exterminists who know exactly what they're doing with their camp followers. And they'll look at you and lick their lips and their eyes will gleam. And they're like, you're not going to stop us. I've run into them many times. I've said, I know your foundation run. This isn't about peace. They're like, you won't stop us. And then another little trendy comes over. And they act all friendly. Oh, hi, I'm liberal. Oh, and start talking to each other like that. But behind the scenes, they're just like, I mean, that's who Bill Gates and all of them are. George Clooney, all of it. It's just like, but it's all on the surface like, hi, I'm non-threatening. You understand that? And they mean business. Now, I can't read George Clooney's heart in these other people, but I know either they're complete useful idiot morons or they are consciously part of this. And I've run into many of these globalists and their minions where they are conscious of it. You didn't think a hardcore tyrant and their coterie and squadrons and armies and gaggles of servant minions actually are going to run around wearing black uniforms and skull caps like the Nazis did you? No, they're going to walk around with limp wrist, acting foppishly. But that's all their cover, because behind them is stealth bombers, tanks, special forces, biochemical weapons. Gigadeath. Gigadeath is what it's called. So a billion or more. So they want Gigadeath times six. They want 6 billion dead, at least conservatively. Six Gigadeath. And, of course, they're telling their upper-level minions, oh, there'll be a billion left, or maybe 250 million, we're not sure. You know, they debate those numbers in different prospectus plans. But if you really read their deeper plans that we've covered here, it's like, no, we may allow a few thousand to live, and then they'll be served by the robotic systems and get on their little space planes, and, oh, I think I'll go to the ruins of Tokyo today, or they'll go to their off-world bases. I'm not saying any of this is actually going to happen. This is what the elite all talk about 24/7. While they have private transport jets landing behind them, full of servants and chefs and people with all the organic certified food grown on their farms. On record, I've shown you all those articles, because they wouldn't eat what they feed us for any amount of money, because they're running chemical biological warfare ops on us. You understand? And that's why all of you that think you're going to win serving evil, all of you out there that get off on serving the evil, go ahead. Go ahead. Because you will be judged by your own masters. They are going to tear you limb from limb. You're going to wish you were torn limb from limb like some horror movie as you die under their chemical and biological warfare slow deaths. The globalists love slow death. They love killing you slow with their treatments once you go into them. And all the blind masses serving them. You want hell? You got it. So go ahead. Don't choose good. Call me a lying kook. Call the truth a lie right in its face. But don't say you weren't warned, because there's a universal spiritual metaphysical rule that you must be given the choice. You must be told the truth. You must be told the way out so you can then deny it before God turns you over to what you love. I have a lot of anger because I love the beauty of this planet. I love my family. I love my life. And I am angry that I'm right and that all of this is just going to continue to rot. And that we're going to look back on today, as I said a year ago, you're going to look back on the present time and everything before it as the good old times. Even if you thought times were bad, you have seen nothing. If they're able to abolish the Bill of Rights and Constitution incrementally, they would then start doing it in big ways. And now the FBI director went before Congress and said, I don't know if the president can kill Americans without trial or arrest here, because the president claims that power. He just wouldn't say it. And they're like,